But there's a reason. There's a reason. There's a reason for this. There's a reason education sucks, and it's the same reason that it will never, ever, ever be fixed. It's never going to get any better. Don't look for it. Be happy with what you got. Because the owners of this country don't want that. I'm talking about the real owners now. The real owners, the big wealthy business interests that control things and make all the important decisions. Forget the politicians. The politicians are put there to give you the idea that you have freedom of choice. You don't. You have no choice. You have owners. They own you. They own everything. They own all the important land. They own and control the corporations. They've long since bought and paid for the Senate, the Congress, the state houses, the city halls. They got the judges in their back pockets. And they own all the big media companies, so they control just about all of the news and information you get to hear. They got you by the balls. They spend billions of dollars every year lobbying to get what they want. Well, we know what they want. They want more for themselves and less for everybody else. But I'll tell you what they don't want. They don't want a population of citizens capable of critical thinking. They don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking. They're not interested in that. That doesn't help them. That's against their interest. That's right. They don't want people...
It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
You know, my kids asked me, they said, you've got to ask the president, does anything scare him?
You know, when Michelle's mad.
No one stops us. No one ever has.
Who are you?
Spies, Agent Walker. The best.
Sir, you should look at this.
Chuck, did you just flash?
He uploaded it.
Oh, Chuck, me.
Chuck?
Guys, I know Kung Fu.
It's NLP.
There is no such thing as aliens, as in extraterrestrial beings from another planet, because there are no such thing as planets. But there are fallen angels who are hiding behind many names and images while serving their spiritual death row while here on Earth. As I said before, a lot of their chess moves was done in the 1900s. Example, the alien movies, 1902. The video game distractions, 1970s. Lower income housing called the Projects, 1936. The oceans were even created in the late 19th century to confuse us on where the actual land masses are, to try to hide God. These are just examples of how much was going on in the 1900s. But back to the so-called aliens. In the book of Genesis chapter 1, God created the firmament which divided the waters above from the waters below. The waters below he gathered together and called them seas. But the waters above, he did nothing to. Which lets me know that outside this firmament is pure water. Nothing has come in or has left out of the firmament. We in here like a baby in the belly of their mother's womb. And when you're inside the womb, you are protected until you enter into this next world that you know nothing about. They shove movies down your throat constantly about aliens, and they give you all shapes, sizes, and variations of them as well. Now ask yourself, how do these jokers know exactly how they look? How they supposed to smell? They supposed way of life, all the way down to what color the slime is that oozes out of their mouth. It's because it is their creation, y'all. But it's not in the way that they've been telling you. They've been very deceptive with it. Let me explain. The fallen angels hide behind a lot of titles and images, y'all. They hide behind the fake dinosaur concept. They hide behind the faces of these so-called world leaders like Trump, Vladimir Putin, the Prime Minister, the Queen. And they will also hide behind these alien concepts in the future. The aliens will be nothing more than some of Satan's most wicked beings, mostly created in laboratories, in this final hour. They are going to fake an alien invasion. I don't know exactly when, but they will. Now, in the height of this so-called alien invasion, they will unleash giants, many who will be dressed in these alien suits. They will unleash superhuman beasts as well as aircrafts that we have never seen. It will create mass hysteria and fear. This is when the so-called world leaders will come together and make an announcement, notifying the people that they will join forces to take out a common enemy. This is the first time a lot of sleep people will see this NWO conjunction between these demons. But for those of you who've been woke for a long time, you will know that these jokers been working together. And this fake alien invasion is from them as well, just like 9/11 was from them collectively. And I call for national martial law. Telling everybody to go inside your house, have the army all up and down your street saying that they're going to protect you while they take out this common issue. Now check this out. Have you all been paying attention to shootings and stuff that have been happening all over the world? Well, haven't you noticed that the SWAT and heavily armored vehicles always seem to show up on the scene? The reason is they are practicing their response time in all major cities with these events. It's practice for the bigger event. Don't y'all know that if they bring this worldwide catastrophe, and when they do, like this fake alien invasion, your law enforcement and army personnel will need to be in their positions fast, or the pyramid from crashing. And when I say fake, I mean fake as in extraterrestrial beings coming from other planets and such. They will be beings, just demonic beings, but they will not be from other planets. They are being created right here as we speak. And they are more like Satan's chief demons dressed in costumes. That's why they do these false flags. Not only is it to promote gun control, to take away your guns, so you'll have nothing to fight with but pots and pans if you did try to rise up, but it's also to prep all law and army personnel for the big event. They're going to make sure they're ready. They ain't worried about you. They're going to make sure they're ready. Once they lock everyone down, they will keep everyone updated via these hypnosis tools, your TV, your cell phones, etc. Do y'all remember when the fires recently broke out in California? And you could tell something was fishy because the fires looked targeted and centralized. Then later we found out it was done by a high-powered laser. See, that's only them testing the things they will be using during this fake alien invasion. The lasers will be used. And I'm afraid they will kill many people to get this chess move done. Let's halt 1 second and take it back to the firmament, though. The scientists of this world have been thirsting. And the Satanists. I mean, yearning to crack that firmament, y'all. They even created missiles with names like Satan 1 and Satan 2 and shot them up at the firmament. And just like every other attempt, they always fail. But if you ask Hillary Clinton, they're going to keep on trying and they'll never give up.
I know we have still not shattered that highest and hardest glass ceiling, but someday someone will, and hopefully sooner than we might think right now.
And I can't believe we just put the biggest crack in that glass ceiling yet. Although we weren't able to shatter that highest, hardest glass ceiling this time, thanks to you, it's got about 18 million cracks in it.
And it may be hard to see tonight,
but we are all standing under a glass ceiling right now.
What she fails to realize and understand is the day that the firmament cracks fully is when the New Jerusalem comes down and God sets up his kingdom. See, when you tell people that nothing can go in or out the firmament unless authorized by God, that throws out the fact that we've been to the moon. When in all actuality, the moon is a light source and nothing can land on it. And for those who still think we've been to the moon, ask them why didn't they bring a star or two on their way back with them? Why didn't they bring back a little bit of that light air in a jar with them? What God has been showing me is, they have been showing you these 7-foot people in Hollywood to get you accustomed to seeing and considering these people and things or these things as normal. So when the leaders of this world make a pact and join these demonic beings, which they are already with them, but they're going to be like super tall. So you will be more apt to accept it. And yes, I said pact. They will eventually make a pact with them or the people whom they call aliens. All right. But really, it will be a group of lab projects that have direct demons working within them. This is why you are given the good alien movies such as E.T. as well, because you too will be coerced into believing that they are good, and that if the little boy in E.T. could live with them, then you can as well. This is when direct demon spirits will start to reveal themselves and ultimately try to take over this world. The red carpet for the Antichrist is being rolled out, and the more evil the world gets, the more they will show themselves. Aliens, as they claim, do not exist. That is a cover for them to usher in the most wicked demons that are under Satan's leadership in the final hour. You mean to tell me, in a world where everybody got a camera, everybody recording, everything going up on WorldStar, there is literally a camera on every business and every street that no one has gotten valid picture of an alien? Only false videos up on YouTube? No one in the hood tied up an alien and beat them down and questioned them like, why are you over here? It's because the demons that will have this alien-like skin are being prepped for the masses in laboratories as we speak. Area 51 is just a shield. Nothing more, nothing less. The real laboratories are underwater. Deep underwater. One word describes what is being done, and that is grooming. They groom the masses before they take action. For instance, Macaulay Culkin was being chased by two horny men in Home Alone back in 1990. Now in 2019, files are about to get their rights. You see, it's grooming. They groom you for the things to come. They groomed everyone to become desensitized to so-called aliens because they one day want you to accept them in your everyday lives. It's a big chess move. The underlay or the overplay. To the believers, be not deceived or dismayed, for the God we serve is greater than anything that we will see or encounter while down here in this snap.
More than the usual amount of deputies. We're practicing for a very high visibility response that could be in response to a threat or an actual activity that takes place somewhere in the United States. So just like we do for wildfires, we're exercising our response to an event that could take place.
With all the videos lately of the flat earth and the dome and the firmament, look at this $1 million dome that they built. Look at that right there. Over $1 million. $1 million to build a dome over the interstate. This is Winston-Salem, North Carolina, of our taxpayer money. But yeah, we live on a spinning wet ball rocket flying through space, right?
Talk about a fish story.
Yeah.
Man, and they're buying it.